Welcome to This Week with Sheriff Dave Phelan, a weekly program here on LSN Television, and we're also carried by our number of our radio affiliates throughout Fairfield County. Do appreciate you, the viewers and listeners that join us each and every week, and certainly the students here at Fairfield Christian Academy and Kelly Roberts, who produces this program, and we're especially grateful to you, the viewers and listeners each and every week. A special program this week we have with us EMA Director John Coaches. Good to see you,
good to see
John.
You, sir.
Before we talk about what all these items are for, tell us a little bit about what the EMA is and what you do.
Sure, we're the we're a disaster preparedness agency. We do a lot of planning. We do a lot of grant work. Basically, our main goal is to support you, the first responders, and the firefighters, and our local elected officials, and in responding to and preparing for disasters.
Great. And speaking of disasters or emergencies, we have a number of things here. What is this for, and what are you going to show us?
This is kind of a sampling of what we'd refer to as an emergency preparedness kit, a disaster planning kit, a family preparedness kit. It goes by many names, but essentially it's the basics that you would need for that first 72 hours after a disaster before our safety services can then resume normal operations and respond to the crisis.
What would be some of the situations where a person may need something like this?
Sure. Yeah, the things that come to mind first are weather-related disasters.
Okay.
Snow and ice, the power outage we received after the strong windstorm last, 2 years ago now, summer, the what they called a derecho, or a high windstorm, where we lost power for 4 days, 5 days. We've had a snow and ice storm in 2008 that we had that same amount of power outage. So lots of situations like that. We also have instances where you would have a hazardous materials response or some other man-made incident that would cause you to either stay in your home or evacuate your home, whichever the professional safety services decide would be best.
Okay, well, what are some of the things we have here?
Sure. We have, starting from this side, the most important thing, water.
Okay.
Now, this is an example of a store-bought container for water, but it also works as well as recycled milk gallon jugs, really anything. But what we also try to reinforce with people is that they have water storage in their home in the form of a hot water tank. You have 40, 60 gallon hot water tanks in your home. As long as you know how to get that water out, you don't need the pressure. You can pull that water out, and there's a long-term supply of water.
And certainly, you know, when you think about a hot water tank, you have the drainage,
right,
at the bottom, so they would maybe need a hose or something to attach to that.
A hose or some kind of smaller container to fill into a larger one, whatever the case may be, and it may be different for every homeowner, so you'd really want to go down there and look at it. We recommend that it's you keep on hand 1 gallon per person per day.
Okay.
And that's for drinking, but it's also for flushing toilets, hand washing, many other things. If you think about how much you use water per day, you'd be amazed how much it adds up to.
And in an emergency, this stuff could be very important.
Absolutely. This could be the lifesaver, honestly. And that's why we start off with this.
The most important, water.
Yeah. Three days. 3 days for water, 3 weeks for food. Those are our limits as a human body can go.
Okay.
Water is most important.
Because if it was a major emergency where you thought you might be down for a couple weeks, don't worry about washing with this. This could be
drinking
something
water
you just need. Okay, what else?
Well, then we go to food. That's our next most important. Some of the commercially available items you see, like here, this is akin to kind of a meal MRE, the old military style.
Okay.
Self-contained, it heats, but it's expensive, and it only has a 3-year shelf life.
Okay.
So you wonder what else is available. You got camping foods, so dehydrated, those type of things. They're easily store-bought, and they also have a longer shelf life, but these are a little more inexpensive.
Okay.
But really, what I suggest, just regular old canned food.
Okay.
That Spam has a 3-year shelf life.
Okay.
The beef stew, 3 to 4 years. These are things that are store-bought that people will really eat on a daily basis.
And there's tuna?
Tuna. All right. Canned tuna, or in this nice, easy plastic package that's easier to pack. All these are great options, and people will actually eat them on a daily basis, so they get recycled through your pantry easier.
We've got water, we've got food.
Right.
What else?
We have some examples of weather radios. A weather radio, the National Weather Service has a weather-only radio frequency. So it only broadcasts weather, and it also broadcasts emergency alerts. We use them, you use them in the dispatch center. This is the same information that we get as the professionals that you can get in your home. What you have there is an example of many different power sources. It's hand crank, it's solar powered, battery backup, and you can plug it in. The great thing about it, you can take that on the go. It can charge your cell phone. You plug it into the back, hand crank, and you can charge your cell phone up. That's a great little tool to have. What we also recommend, this is more of a home model.
I like that though.
It's nice. Because, you know, the cellular companies have gone out of their way to make their towers and their cell phone sites really disaster resistant. But
right.
You still have to charge your battery.
Okay.
That's a great tool to have when you have no power for a week. This is more.
And then again, this is you want enough for maybe several weeks.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, it starts with 3 days, but. You know, you can prepare as long as you'd like to.
And I would think where you store these things is important too. You wouldn't want it in a part of the house where you had where it could be vulnerable to a tornado, right?
Yeah, you would want to start in a nice, cool, dry place because some of these items are heat tolerant and that type of thing. But also a place where you know you're going to go for safety.
Okay.
If you have a first floor home, maybe it's an internal room. You know, you want to put as many doors and walls between you and the outside as possible.
Okay, great. Okay.
So this one is a tone alert weather radio, and the only difference this is on that weather service radio frequency, it sends out a tone that activates your radio. So it can be totally quiet for weeks on end, but when there's an alert, it'll fire up, it'll make a loud noise, and then you'll hear what the emergency is. This is what we use in the dispatch center.
And I would think this would be important even if you decided not to do this.
Absolutely. This is the greatest public information piece you can have, because we're going to do many alerts over this type of
thing. And what would something like this cost, John?
This one's a really nice upper end model, probably about $40.
Okay.
But then they sell them as low as $15.
Okay.
We worked with Channel 4 and Channel 6 in the past to do those, to bring these to you, like at the Kroger.
Okay.
We've seen those around. We work with them to have those bulk sales dates where we can come in and get these radios really inexpensive.
Okay, moving right along here.
Right, so the next most important thing, first aid kit. Band-aids, Neosporin, all the things you kind of need in an emergency. This is a small example, and you can make it as large or as small as possible, but having the first aid kit and having someone trade in first aid in your home, it's invaluable, because inevitably you're going to, you know, receive some injuries in these type of disasters. There's nails and debris everywhere. It's just going to happen.
Because the reality is, if we have a major emergency in our county, it may be a long time before the fire department, the sheriff's office, the police department can get to you.
Absolutely.
I mean, there may be roads that are blocked. So really, this is the best thing you can do to be prepared for those unforeseen circumstances.
Absolutely. And we're bound to see hospitals overloaded. So that first aid at home can be a real lifesaver, because you might be experiencing a longer wait at the hospital.
I wonder today how many people have these. Have you ever
tried? You know, I believe the percentages would be awfully low.
I would think so.
But you'd be
amazed. I mean, we have some things in our home. We have like food and different things, but I hadn't thought about, you know, having this much water and things on hand. And I think it's a real good point that you made about the hot water tank.
Absolutely. And I think people who have experienced things like camping or have gone on long trips, they might have some of these things and not really realize that they're prepared for it. We camp a lot as a family, and we know we've got our disaster supplies kit is really just our camping kit.
Right.
You know, if you think about it in that way, you're really prepared. It's just putting all these pieces together and storing them together and making sure that they're up to date.
Okay.
So next most important, flashlight.
We have water, food, radio, alert system. Okay.
A flashlight. Or multiple flashlights.
Right.
They're great to have. Obviously, we've got them around the house. We're prepared for power outages. But having it ready, having it, you know that the batteries are charged, you know it's going to work.
Right.
That's the best way to do it.
Right. You have the batteries in there, and it's something, it's not laying on the shelf, and you turn it on, there's not light.
You don't steal the batteries for the remote control or you know, anything else. You have it ready, and you test them. We suggest people test their flashlights when they test their smoke detectors. Usually,
great idea.
Usually right around October, actually, the equinox, I think, is when we do the smoke detector tests.
Good.
So test your flashlights, make sure that they're operational. We suggest that over candles because candles present that fire hazard.
Right.
So you want to stay away from that long term. You have to want to be around that candle source. Next thing we have here is the whistle. This one's a little fancy. It's got a compass. It's four function.
Okay.
Magnifier, thermometer, and a compass. But whistle, what this is important for is if you are in your basement and your home is destroyed, you're eventually going to run out of voice. You really don't want to scream. But blowing on a whistle is going to be louder, and you're going to be able to alert people what's going on.
Boy, that is a great idea.
Yeah.
So if there's an emergency, you've got your whistle to alert first responders.
Right.
And the other thing I would think is if there is that emergency, make sure that you've got that cell phone with you.
Absolutely.
You know, if it's laying, if there's a collapse, you're in the basement and part of the house, and the cell phone's on the dresser, may not be able to help you.
Right. Absolutely. So keeping your cell phone handy, maybe keeping a charger around. To go with our hand crank weather radio that charges cell phones, that's a great thing to have. But
right.
Having that whistle, it alerts people. And also, if you're in a situation where there's danger involved, we've always suggested that women carry whistles with
okay.
them. This is the same concept. Carry it with you, have it. This is a big version. We used to give out the little small versions, the little plastic versions. They're great to have, put on a keychain. Whatever it takes to get people alerted to the possible danger or your situation, that's what the whistle's for.
Okay.
So now we're going to go into kind of some hygiene items,
okay.
is what I like to call it. We're familiar with these disinfectant wipes that are really handy. I know mothers and the baby wipes, they really be able to clean without soap and water.
Mm-hmm.
The first preference is to use soap and water, but in an emergency, we might not have that. We might be on a limited water supply.
Right.
So we use some of these antibacterial products, the squirt bottles, the wipes. And then, you know, these baby wipes come real handy. In handy if you're not able to have water pressure to take a shower. This is kind of refreshing, I guess, to it could be a long time, so you'd want to be prepared if you're not going to have the opportunity to take a shower to kind of clean up, I guess, as best.
That would be helpful.
Yeah.
That'd be helpful.
Next in here we have what we call a dust mask. Just simple operation, obviously. A cotton t-shirt works, but you know, when you're in a situation where there's debris, you want to have that respiratory protection.
You know, John, we are really running out of time. What I'd like to do is have you back next week.
Okay.
And we'll kind of go through some of these things real briefly and kind of take and kind of get the rest of the stuff explain about some of the other items that,
sure.
that people may need. And talk about some other things that you do as the EMA director and some other programs that you offer to our county.
Okay,
so
great.
Can you join us next week?
Absolutely.
I appreciate that. John Cochis, our EMA director here in Fairfield County, covering some things that you should have in your home stored away in case there is some kind of emergency. And I'll tell you, I've really learned a lot. I really have, John. I appreciate that. And I know the viewers and listeners enjoy that. And I appreciate Kelly Roberts, who's our director of this program, put this together and reminded me about a week ago. She said, Sheriff, I think we need to be doing more of these type of displays as part of the program. And certainly we're going to be trying to do those things in the future. The clock on the wall says we're out of time, so be sure to join us next week. Do appreciate the kids here at Fairfield Christian Academy, JT Burgess, and all the people that make this program possible. Until next week, same time, same place. God bless, and we'll see you right here.
Severe weather can destroy a home in seconds. There's no time to think, only time to act. Have a kit so you're ready for any emergency. Develop a plan for what you and your family will do before disaster strikes and stay informed during severe weather any way you can. It can be the difference between losing your possessions and losing your life. Just ask the owners of this house.
Visit ready.gov for ways to prepare your family for emergencies.